You mean the Levi dude? No, whoever he is.
He's videoing.
You guys don't know who it is. No. You don't know who Levi is? Okay.
No, I guess you know.
He's recording.
Gone. Okay.
Yeah, all right.
I'm curious.
That is it.
You know, if I say it now, it's on camera.
Please
you
say
can,
it.
You can be edited it out.
He's gonna edit it. You know he's not gonna edit it out.
Is this the dude
I'm
who
not gonna
specifically
say it.
Looked up the video of? Okay,
no, that's Josmar.
That's Josmar.
Okay. Okay.
I have no idea who it is.
Okay. Hi, welcome to kind of an end of the year at heart video. We just wanted to share some things that God has put on our hearts. So,
like my shirt.
I mean, technically, it's on his heart.
I mean, technically,
it's
like
on his abdomen.
Flesh. And
yeah.
Are you sure? Get some out.
I mean, after
there's no bones left.
Yeah.
Okay.
You have to love
there are like four different movies that I could reference to just that conversation.
Okay. So the whole point of this video is just
to be weird.
To share what God has been doing this year. We have been discussing the whole point of the YouTube channel and, you know, basically, creators talk about we need to create a story. We need to tell a good story. And I personally have been struggling with the idea of telling a story that's interesting about what we're doing without being like, hey, look at the good things that we're doing. You should give us money. Or, you know, doing our good deeds before men rather than just doing what God asks us to do. And also struggling with the idea of telling a story about our family because while we think we're hilarious, it's not necessarily like gonna make sense to most people.
It's a lot of
things are hilarious.
And beyond that, it's just a matter of that's not the story we're supposed to be telling. And we know that we want to tell God's story, the story of what He's been doing and what He continues to do and how much He loves His people and.
Has a sense of humor.
He does have a sense of humor, thankfully, because otherwise we'd be in big trouble.
And there'd be no platypus.
True. Well, if he didn't have a sense of humor, I don't think we would have the capacity to laugh.
Baby platypus are really cute.
Smile like
understand.
This.
British smile.
Okay.
Or a bulldog
so,
smile.
Nathan, general. Will you start us off?
No kids working.
Oh. Youngest first.
Youngest first.
Okay. One thing I've seen God do in our lives this summer was He gave us the opportunity to help other people to use the skills He's given us, mainly Him, to bless them and encourage them in their work.
Yeah, good.
What is about eternity next?
No, next, you. Snuffleupagus.
Yeah, Snuffleupagus. Start talking.
Yeah, Lennyluppagus.
He gave us a chance to come here and do what He had planned for us, which is a lot of stuff that we really didn't think we would be doing. Like sheetrock.
Should I put subtitles on her speech?
Yeah, please.
Well, because she's sick, she's slurring.
Comment down below if you need subtitles.
Other than that, I'm already really quiet.
Yeah. So what you said earlier was that God provided the way for us to move back to Montana, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So
interpretations are amazing.
Lip reading works wonders.
Not when they don't move their lips.
Yeah, like she does.
And they don't have lips.
Anyway. So we've seen God move in a lot of different ways.
Bella's turn.
I'm sorry.
Bella doesn't have a turn. We skipped her.
I'm fine with that. That means I don't have to talk.
You have to talk.
Yeah, Chick-fil-A and talk.
God's given us lots of new friends and a sometimes challenging but interesting place to work.
Yeah.
For those two at least. Because they won't let me get a job yet.
Need one.
She needs to finish high school before she gets a job.
She needs
That's
to,
not necessarily yeah. everyone's path.
I can't finish high school until we do the thingy so I can finish high school.
Okay. She needs to talk louder.
I drive too much already getting into work. I need a third one.
Okay, so one of the ways.
A lawnmower?
Lawyer's permit.
And this is why a story about our family doesn't work, because we interrupt each other and we randomly chase rabbit trails and sometimes come back to what we're trying to talk about.
No, we don't. Like forget about happens. It completely.
Oh my goodness.
We almost never come back to what we're talking about.
As long as we get back to what God wants us to talk about.
Are we talking about?
Who are we talking
Stop.
About?
What?
So, some of the ways that we have seen God work, I'm trying to ignore Nathan because he's being obnoxious on purpose. Let's see. Okay, first, he directed us as to what to do and asked, you know, challenged us. Are we going to trust him, or are we going to trust what we can see and what we can plan and what we can provide?
The experience of God.
Yes, going through experiencing God. Last spring. Anyhow.
I was playing a zombie game.
So what are some of the ways you think you've seen God work?
I thought you were going to list more things.
I was going to, but he's distracting.
She couldn't remember
so.
Them. We lived through having COVID.
Multiple times.
Yes.
That's true. God has been faithful in that way as well.
Our brain cells haven't survived this.
Our brain cells
we
live in New Mexico.
I mean, we're down to our last two group brain cells at this point, so
we've already lost
we
them both.
We went camping overnight, and I was shivering and shivering, and I actually thought I was going to die, but I'm still alive.
Okay.
Yes, that's right.
So, some of the other ways that God has provided and just done big things, like the girl said, friends. I mean, we had some friends in Oregon for sure, but the girls making some new friends here so quickly was also really nice.
You mean people that are our age?
No, there were some your age. Amber, Katrina,
okay.
And she's a little older.
Amber, Katrina, back, Sabrina.
Okay, back
and
to the
a couple other people in youth group.
Okay, anyhow.
Yes.
Once
so, a
week. What, I don't know what else you want to share, because I keep getting interrupted and I don't have any idea where I'm trying to go, because
we're lost.
Sad. Probably should have written a roadmap out.
Well, I would have, but you told me not to.
That's because it's called impromptu. Camera's that way, if you're wondering. This is why I have to deal with
it. And cut.
Nope.
So obviously God provided for us this year, because we are not where we started out at. We are in a much different place. We're in a different state. Obviously we're currently living in our travel trailer, which has its own issues, but God has provided for it and blessed us through these different things we've had to face. We haven't frozen to death yet. Our water is mostly working right now. That's pretty cool. It actually leaked all out yesterday on its own. Pretty awesome. And everything else came out just fine, too.
Oh.
At least that's not, you know, just broken.
We don't need to go into details.
We have power. We have heat. God has provided the food we need. And our puppies haven't died yet. That's big surprise, actually.
Yeah, for some of them.
And he's provided for us to do lots of work and help people that we didn't know we'd be able to reach. And we had no way of reaching else than God and paving the way for us to do such. So, it's been kind of...
chaotic?
Well, chaotic is definitely true. I was going to say meandering in some of the things we've gotten done. But it's been going that way so that we learn more to rely on God and do things His way. Because if we try and plan it out, it doesn't work out.
Like, well, most it's just of the churches that we had planned for us to go to do stuff, we didn't end up going to.
No, we ended up spending more time at most of the churches that we were at and building more relationships from that. And
Kay went to different churches.
Yeah, in different churches we hadn't planned on, and
it helped individuals that we didn't know about.
Yeah.
They need help.
Yeah. It just, it was what God wanted rather than what we had planned, and I'm very thankful that we didn't hold so tightly to our plans that we missed what God had for us to do. So, I guess moving forward, we are excited to see what God has for next year. We look forward to hearing what God has done in your life this last year. And
I have a live stream with audio and video at the same time.
At the same time.
On the first try.
Members of the board.
So yes, we will try. We will try and have a video probably next month. With the entire At Heart board. Sometime in the next few months, we'll try for that. I know they have their own amazing stories of the way God has just provided and shown up in such huge ways that were unexpected and completely inexplicable, except that it was God. And same thing with us, like the folks on the way to Oregon with the metal roofing coming off their shed. That was scary, but if we hadn't been there, it might not have gone as well for those people. Thank you. Gross.
Nice sound effect.
Anyway, they're just little things. They seem little until you realize it's not just a coincidence that everything, every interaction is an opportunity, and every relationship is potentially something that God wants you to develop so that you can share the gospel, so that you can encourage someone, so that you can help comfort someone. And I know God has a lot more for this next year coming up, and hopefully we'll have some new surprises to share with you all in the next month or so, in the coming months at least. So
next year, tomorrow.
Next year it starts in the next few hours.
Yeah.
That depends where you're at.
In the next few hours.
It already is next year anymore.
And in Tokyo.
Yeah.
In the U.S. It'll be in the next few hours.
In the U.S.
So with that, thank you so much for being a part of what God has done in our lives. Thank you for being a part of what God is continuing to do. And just thank you for keeping us in prayer and encouraging us and laughing along with us and at us. And
more at us than anything else.
Well, maybe, but we're laughing too, so it's fair.
Laughing at each other.
We just look forward to sharing with you all the things that God is doing in our family and with At Heart Ministries. So we look forward to what God has for the new year, and would love to hear what your thoughts are, what you have planned, and I think that's all of my rambling. So, Nathan, do you want to pray?
Yes.
Will you pray, or do you have something
such.
Else to say?
I have other stuff to say, because Emily's amazing. We'll get some videos out, and we're going to get back into the swing of things, doing other stuff too, with other videos like our movie reviews that our movie Addicted Children love to not film, because they do. And hopefully we'll be actually getting out our midweek warm-ups every week on time.
In the middle of the week, even.
Yeah, midweek. We'll find out. But if there is anything that you guys want us to make videos about, you need to let us know in the comments down below, and or via our website.
Yeah.
All the good stuff. But with that, let's go ahead and bow in prayer. Dear Lord, and we thank you today, and thank you that you are the great and mighty God, and that you work in all these different ways and through things that we can't see you working in. But we see the results of how great and mighty you are. We just ask that you would continue to work through this ministry, because it's truly your ministry, and just ask that you bless the efforts that are being used to bring glory to your name, and just use them to do something big that no one else can take credit for, so everyone knows all around us that it is you working. Just thank you for everything you've done. Thank you for this year that you've given us, and look forward to the next year coming up. In your wonderful name, I pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen. All right, thanks. We'll talk to you guys soon. Shalom.
Bye.